Hey guys, how are you? Welcome back to another episode of The Grumpy Geek, where you can always catch some new original content on all things geeky and nerdy. As usual, I'm your host, Cassius Samuels, and today I had some free time, so I decided to do a video about my favorite lightsaber duels from the Star Wars animated universe. Just because Star Wars is one of the greatest geekdoms of all times and one of my favorite things in the universe, I thought it would be fun to put together a list of my favorite animated lightsaber duels. So what I did was basically gathered up about six of what I believe to be the best duels from the entire Star Wars animated universe, meaning Clone Wars and Star Wars Rebels, and put them together with a little commentary from yours truly to explain my reasoning behind choosing each duel in the spots that I did. But as we all know though, between the Clone Wars and Star Wars Rebels, there have been so many compelling, awe-inspiring duels that the task of trying to narrow it down to only six was indeed a difficult one. So if I leave one off the list that you felt like was better, just keep in mind that this is all opinion-based, and it's okay for your list to be completely different than mine. So with that being said, let's go ahead and dive right into the video, shall we?
Your master has deceived you into believing you can become a Jedi.
Get ready to fly us out of here. You know what I do in hopeless situations?
Yeah, blow stuff up.
Aim for the walkers.
To me, the fight between Kanan, Ezra, and Vader is most definitely one of my favorite duels to start with on this list, just for the simple fact that it was the first appearance of Darth Vader in the animated universe after his fall as Anakin Skywalker in Revenge of the Sith. This was a fierce battle to me, and I felt like it vividly showcased Vader's deadly skills as a duelist, as well as demonstrated his awesome command over the Force with several jaw-dropping feats that he performed in the heat of combat. I thought this duel stayed very true to everything that has made Vader the iconic villain that he is today, as he showed no mercy with his relentless attacks that exemplified tactical prowess and elegant precision. Kanan and Ezra were clearly outmatched in this fight, which becomes evident almost immediately as the fight starts, when Vader nearly decapitates Ezra with his own lightsaber using the Force. He then turns around after that, lands a well-placed strike on Kanan's shoulder, and then turns around after that and uses the Force at the end of the battle to telekinetically shield himself from being crushed in an avalanche of wreckage. To me, that was just pure gold. So to me, this battle was very satisfying and left nothing to be desired at all, in my opinion, at number 6.
Thank you. why you want children.
Well, who doesn't want to be a mother?
Like the duel between Kanan, Ezra, and Darth Vader before this, this fight between Ahsoka and the Inquisitors is one of my favorite because it showcases how far Ahsoka had come since her days as a young Padawan in the Clone Wars. Not only that, this battle was one of the first times we saw Ahsoka engage in combat with her two newly constructed white-bladed lightsabers as well. On top of that, I also thought that the fight choreography in this duel was superlative, as Ahsoka's full range of dueling skills were put on display during the showdown. Even being outnumbered 2-1, Ahsoka quickly overwhelmed the ill-prepared Inquisitors, who were unable to land a single blow on the former apprentice of Anakin Skywalker, as she stylishly disabled and disarmed them both rather easily. Ahsoka even has a moment of greatness in this fight, where she puts away both of her lightsabers and manages to catch the Seventh Sister's lightsaber in mid-strike while deactivating it, which went a long way in proving that Ahsoka was indeed going to be a threat to Darth Vader, as she clearly verified her superiority to his newest disciples. So for me, in the end, there was no way this fight was getting left off the list. That's why I threw it in at number 5.
Ready?
Like you even had to ask.
You master Qui-Gon Jinn, I gutted him while you stood helpless and watched. How did that make you feel, Obi-Wan? Your rage has unbalanced you. That is not the Jedi way, is it?
We're outmatched.
You want to run?
I learned from watching you.
Funny. The cockpit?
Now! Come on! Working on it.
Come on, hurry! Now would be a good time.
Anybody who watched the Clone Wars series knows that there were no shortages of intense lightsaber duels throughout the show's run, so there were plenty to choose from when it came to making this list. For me, one of the duels that stood out the most to me was the 2-on-2 battle royale between Obi-Wan Adventress and Darth Maul and his brother Savage Opress. This was a duel that was set up due to unusual circumstances, and it also served as a rematch for Obi-Wan and Darth Maul, who had not dueled since Maul was cut in half by Obi-Wan on Naboo back in the Phantom Menace movie. To me, this was another battle full of beautiful fight choreography, as Obi-Wan and Ventress did their best to match the ferocity of their opponents in close quarter combat. One of the things that made this duel so great to see, in my opinion, was also the return of Darth Maul to the series, as he attempted to get his revenge against the Jedi who defeated him and left him for dead so long ago. And even though Obi-Wan lost this duel and was forced to retreat with Ventress in the end, I still feel like the duel was one of the best in the entire series due to the circumstances leading up to the event and the intimate narrative that the duel was framed through. So for me, this fight will always hold a spot in the lightsaber duel hall of fame, no matter how many times I decide to rearrange this list in the future. I feel like lots of people watching this video would put other lightsaber duels from the Clone Wars in this number 3 spot over this fight between Maul and Pre Vizsla, but for me, the truth of the matter is that I feel like this is one of the single most entertaining Maul-related lightsaber showdowns in all of Clone Wars, period. To me, Pre Vizsla was definitely one of the baddest non-force users in the galaxy next to Cad Bane the Bounty Hunter. So when this showdown finally rolled around between him and Maul, it was hard not to be overwhelmed with excitement at seeing the two of them go head-to-head for control of the entire Mandalorian Empire. The fight itself was very well coordinated. The story was unique since it was two well-established bad guys in the Star Wars universe that were going at each other's throats instead of the two of them uniting against the common threat posed by the Jedi and the Republic. And there was plenty of action as two almost evenly matched duelists went head-to-head to see who would be the true alpha male and rule the Mandalorian Empire, like I said. And even though Maul did not use the Force very much in this battle, since I feel like it would have given him a clear advantage, I felt like the fight was very polarizing and massively entertaining due to this. Because despite Pre Vizsla not being a Force sensitive, I feel like this battle was still on another level of intensity, because Pre Vizsla was able to hold his own in this fight by relying on his arsenal of weaponry and strategic battle tactics that pushed Maul's ability as a duelist to the absolute max. I also love the fact that Maul won this fight and took control of Mandalore, which basically catapulted him to the highest heights of power that he had ever managed to attain in Star Wars history. So for me, this duel will forever be one of my favorite highlights from the Clone Wars series.
I won't leave you. Not this time.
Then you will die.
Vader versus Ahsoka is probably one of the most significant and most anticipated duels to ever take place in the Star Wars animated universe. And for me, it delivered one of the most intimate battles to ever take place in the Star Wars universe as a whole, in my opinion. With all the history from the Clone Wars, Ahsoka leaving the Jedi Order, Anakin falling to the dark side, this battle was just something that fans of the two characters have been patiently waiting for a long time. And when it finally hit screens, it was truly a magnificent sight to behold. Everything from the choreography to the background music to the aesthetic placement of the battle itself in the Sith Temple, it was just all on point as the battle itself unfolded into a display of poetic tragedy as Ahsoka kept struggling with the truth that her old master had in fact become the deadly dark emissary of the Sith. The whole fight was absolutely heart-wrenching to watch, as many aesthetic parallels could be recognized between this duel and the duel between Anakin and Obi-Wan that transpired on Mustafar at the end of Revenge of the Sith. And this only further added a more compelling factor to the narrative surrounding the situation for me. So in the end, I feel like this was one of the most prolific battles in Star Wars history, and I believe that anyone who says differently is out of their mind.
There is no mercy. Do not worry. I'm not going to kill you. I have other uses for you.
When it comes to the final duel on this list, I feel like there's no need for any kind of a summary or commentary, but I'm going to give some anyway. As someone who was a lifelong fan of Star Wars, I have no problem saying that I feel like the Clone Wars series is the greatest Star Wars series ever made at this current point in time. And as such, I feel like this duel between Sidious, Maul, and Oppress is not only one of the best animated duels in the animated universe, but I also feel like it's one of the best duels in all of Star Wars, period. This fight was another one of those highly anticipated fights that built up over the course of several seasons ever since we as fans witnessed the return of Darth Maul to the Star Wars universe and watched his rise to power with his brother Savage. Fans all knew it was only a matter of time before Darth Sidious was alerted to his activities, and when he was, the moment of truth would finally be upon him. And when it finally came, we were not disappointed. For me, this fight was one of the most impeccably choreographed duels in all of Star Wars, with several memorable moments, with the end result not being a surprise, as it reminded us just how powerful the Lord of the Sith truly is. Sidious was pretty much always in control for the entire fight, turning a few times he seemed to be on the ropes to his advantage, such as when Savage force pushed him off the balcony and he simply just used the force to grab both of them and pull them with him. So for me, this duel will always be number one, or close to number one in my heart, because of the raw viciousness displayed by the opponents and the importance of the impact that this battle had on the current state of affairs in the Star Wars universe at the time. So there you have it. There it is. That's my top six favorite animated lightsaber duels from Star Wars. Let me know if you guys thought I got it right, or if your list differs from mine. Go ahead, share your list down below in the comments. As always, please don't forget to share, like, and subscribe if you thought there was any entertainment value in this video. And I will see you lovely nerdy geeks later. May the Force be with you, and I'll see you next time. Peace.